Good morning, students. Here I am Ashish Srivastava with a new topic of science, that is the changes around us. So let's talk. In this topic, we will include the introduction, changes, kind of changes, right? So let's talk about one by one about these topics. First, changes. What are the changes? Students, you have seen in your daily life around us, so many changes are occurs. Change means something when something is converted into different kind of the thing. For example, if you having the dough, your mama rolled it and make the chapatis for you. So now dough is converted into chapati. The things remains the same, only the shape and sizes change. So it is one kind of the change. Like you are now small, and after few years you will be grown up and become old. So it is also a change. You are change in different height or the different weight. If you have the piece of paper and you torn it or tear or cut into the pieces, it is also one kind of the change. Either the paper, the material is remains the same, only the size and shape is changed. Cracking of crackers, firing crackers, and melting of ice. These are also the example of changes. In melting of ice or melting of wax or burning of a matchstick is also the example of changes. So that kind of the changes you find in your daily life. Also, can you tell me or give me some examples of the changes that happens around us? Yes, you can. Guys, have you ever feel that when you stretch a rubber band, it becomes lengthy, but when you release the force, it comes in back into its original shape? When you freeze the water, it converted into the ice, but when you heat the ice, it again converted into the water. Also, when you burn the piece of paper converted into the ash. Or something like, so many changes, like when you cook the, making the omelette from the egg, so egg is converted into omelette. So what is the difference between these changes, like melting of ice and burning of paper, either cooking of food, that is omelette. So you can see, guys, in previous example, when we melt the ice, ice is converted into water, and when you freeze this water, it again converted into the ice. While when you burn the paper, paper is burned and converted into ash, but you are now not able to convert the ash into again into the paper. So with the help of these example, you can understood that the changes are two kind. One is reversible and second is irreversible. So what are the reversible changes? Reversible changes are those in which we can found by a process the original thing or original material, that are known as the reversible changes. For example, melting of ice, already I told you, melting of wax, and making the chapatis from the dough, or when you inflating of balloons. These are the examples of the reversible change. When you release the gas, balloon again come into its original shape. Stretching of band, rubber band, it is also the example of reversible change. When you release the force, rubber band again come back into its original shape. So these are the examples of reversible changes. Second is irreversible changes. Irreversible changes are those changes in which the something or the things cannot come back into its original form, like burning of piece of paper. So ash never converted into the paper again by any process. Similarly, cooking of food, when the food is cooked, it not again converted into its ingredient like again into raw potatoes or raw lauki, etc., etc., or raw paneer or whatever you are like, or like the example of egg, you cannot convert the omelette again into the egg. So these examples stand as the examples of the irreversible changes. So today I have told you about two main kind of the changes. One is reversible and second is irreversible. So write, give some more examples, write them into comment box or send it to me on WhatsApp group in my personal number, not in group. So guys, that's all for today. Tomorrow we will come with the next part of this episode. Thank you. Have a nice day.